So I finally got around to watching Godzilla Minus One. I actually spent the extra $5 to upgrade my Netflix package. Yeah, I'm going all the way premium. I got the 4K. I got to watch this in high dynamic range. And you know what? I was not expecting Grave of the Fireflies meets Jaws. But that's a good thing. It's just, well, before we get into it, I want to give a quick mention to my buddies over at Caldera+Lab.com. If you want some sunscreen that can withstand Godzilla's heat ray, yeah, I can say that because it's a fictional character, check out the Face SPF. Use my promo code FRY15 to save 15% at checkout. So our story starts in the final days of World War II. A kamikaze pilot has landed on an island rather than into an enemy carrier. Oh, he's chickened out. There doesn't seem to be anything wrong with his plane. Well, that night, Godzilla attacks. And this isn't your normal Godzilla. This is very large dinosaur Godzilla. Oh, he's such a coward. He failed to shoot the giant when he had a chance to take it out. And people died. And all because he lacked the heroics, his home village also got destroyed. And that's where I was getting the Grave of the Fireflies vibes with the solemn look as we see the dilapidated buildings and the people just getting by, though it really didn't get that heavy into drama. This is a film that has that desaturized, let's make it look like it's in the 40s look about it, which kind of takes me out of the film slightly. And don't get on me with the performances. I watched the English dub because this is a special effects affair. Won an Oscar. I don't need to be distracted by reading. He bumps into homegirl, takes care of a baby that's not theirs, and finds some dangerous work, taking out mines. This is where things get a little Jaws-like. Now, the mine crew, likable group over here, as time goes by, they're very effective at taking out the mines, but they're also deployed to fight Godzilla, who with the atomic testing on Bikini Atoll has become quite big. Godzilla has a lot of the abilities you're used to seeing. There's some swimming. There is the heat ray, the atomic breath, if you will. I like the way how the plates along the back like light up and spring into action. It looks pretty good. Does this look that amazing? In some parts, there's not a lot of bad effects. But yeah, all the Godzilla stuff is the best Godzilla stuff I've seen. Though I haven't watched the American Godzilla stuff since Cranston got involved. Godzilla Minus One, I have no idea why it's called such, does a good job of making the drama about the people, having a much better people-focused plot than I think anybody could have possibly expected. We just wanted dumb giant stuff clashing with buildings, get some tanks involved. You get a little bit of that. I actually appreciate how they had a very nuanced, novel approach to trying to take out Godzilla by sinking him. I like the movie. I give it 3 out of 4 stars. Now I want to get into some spoilerly complaints. So the finale of Godzilla Minus One does feature suitable foreshadowing. The camera also drifts away during an important part where the ground crew guy is walking Kamikaze through the special setup in his plane. He's going to try to lure Godzilla away from Tokyo, get him out in the bay, get him out in open water, and then they're going to wrap him up with some Freon emitting like large refrigerators. They're going to create bubbles, sink them, and then deploy a balloon, put them through the decompression phase. But Kamikaze here, he's got another plan. He has to atone for his sins, all right? So he requests that they get a bomb loaded up in his plane. He's going to fly into the mouth of Godzilla. But he was also given an ejector seat. They mention ejector seat when they're going through the planning. No one has to die here, but it looked like he was going to go off script. But also homegirl, she saved him during a blast from Godzilla, which I have no idea why it blew stuff out and then back in. Does that defy physics? It wasn't a vacuum? I don't know. We're assuming she's dead. There's actually a late in movie telegram that arrives so we can just compound these reveals. Oh, hey, homegirl actually survived. And good thing you had that ejector seat. Let's walk you through a flashback of me telling you how we put the ejector seat in there. Didn't need to see that. They did everything they could to preserve the reveal of this guy actually ejecting. It goes so quick when he flies into Godzilla, and this is actually the killing blow. I would have kind of preferred to see the sink and the decompression work, but it didn't. It softened him up, maybe. Bomb in the head, disassembles. He looks like the Rockbiter from the Neverending Story, just crumbling apart. And we get our happy ending, though maybe homegirl's missing an eye. I like that that's not really said. I have no idea why she has a black ink tattoo growing upon her. Is this radiation sickness? She wasn't directly in contact with Godzilla. She's not the next Godzilla, but Godzilla itself. Oh, well, we can't kill Godzilla. Let's sneak in a shot of Godzilla going Wolverine and repairing itself. I didn't need to see that. I kind of like the idea that there are multiple Godzillas. If this was a Godzilla that got killed, we could feel joy. Hey, this was a bad one. Maybe there's a good Godzilla. It can't be the only thing in its whole phylum. This doesn't make any sense. So yeah, these are complaints for a good movie. Kind of glad I watched it on Netflix. The 4K came through, as I thought would be the case. They seriously gimp the data rate. Your megabytes per second is way down if you don't get the premium. Everything looks like a washed out garbage filter, like a Barbara Walters interview. Just everything's so blurry and smeared. Way better with the 4K. Unfortunately, they paywalled that, and your senator is doing nothing to stop Netflix from doing so.
Hey, it's Vaughn's mom again, so I just wanted to remind you that instead of buying Vaughn's weird pictures online in various states of undress, you can just bookmark his Amazon affiliate link, and then when you shop, throw it on Amazon, he gets a few pennies here and there.